First, I would start saying that as paediatric, I'm super nervous, so I don't know if it's excitement or what it is, but I will try to do my best, okay? I will just start by saying, that energy is key for MSF operations, not only to provide, to use biomedical equipment like oxygen concentrators, but also IT equipment or to store vaccines and drugs, for example. And now that we are moving on to more and more complex operations, it's basic to ensure a reliable energy supply, no? And to provide, as you can see there, technically, socially, environmentally, and economically responsible energy solutions adapted to context and needs and in order to offer the best setup to our operations. But always by taking into consideration the three priorities, that it's like ensuring the safety of the people, the protection of devices, and the continuity of service. And this is what we call the energy vision, that is like a common vision or a common desired energy scenario, but taking into consideration the challenges, the operational challenges that we are facing right now. And we can see this better in a video, if it works. Yep.
The OCB energy vision. Energy is essential for our projects. Lights, heating, cooling, biomed, water supply, and IT equipment are all energy dependent. Without them, we couldn't provide an effective service to our beneficiaries. At the logistics department, we are constantly working to ensure that the electrical systems in our projects are safe and reliable for our patients and our staff. However, we think there is the potential to expand our idea of electricity to include other energy sources. The Energy Vision Project is the first step in the transition towards appropriate energy concepts. We have mapped the energy realities globally within our projects and seen that our operations are increasingly demanding. Last longer and require growing amounts of energy to power not just our hospitals, but also our offices, guest houses, and warehouses, which also add to our carbon footprint. We have asked each other how we approach energy challenges and needs, and have seen the potential to create new and better solutions with broad, interdisciplinary collaborations. Together with the MSF Sweden Innovation Unit, a roadmap has been formulated. We are proposing future activities for how to better supply our field staff with the tools, knowledge, and equipment to deliver the best energy service possible to our beneficiaries. So, what are you waiting for? Join us on this journey today, the Energy Vision Team.
This was my strategy not to speak that much. So what did we do with this energy vision? How did we apply it? So we applied this vision in a practical case, that is the case that I'm going to present today, that it's the Kenema Paediatric Hospital. So I would talk first like about the general energy vision on one hand, and on the other hand about the Kenema Paediatric Hospital and how did we put theory into practice. So just to give you a little bit of background of the Kenema project or the Kenema Paediatric Hospital, is it a 140-bed hospital with three main objectives, that is reduce mother and child mortality, provide safe quality health care in a LASA endemic area, and contribute to the development of competencies of health staff. It's a hospital that is going to be built, it's going to be built in three construction phases. The first phase is the pediatric care. It's now being built until at the end of this year. Then the second phase, we will tackle the obstetric care and neonatology. And third phase, fifth phase, an extension, depending on the activities. So now we are in the first phase until the end of this year. So how did we apply the energy vision or the vision that we saw in the and the video to the Kenema project. Well, first, what we wanted to do is just to know where are we in terms of energy within MSF, no? I mean, what is the MSF energy picture in order to evaluate and develop a sustainable or more appropriate energy solutions, no? So we took the data from the MSF Operational Center Brussels, that it takes 26% of MSF field operations. And we did a research and where we use quantitative and qualitative methods. Quantitative methods, we use internal databases, we use several questionnaires that we use it in the field. And qualitative, we did some interviews, we did also five workshops and external literature review, et cetera, no? And we work not only with the LOC department, but with several other departments within the organization. So we, in this process, it was key, the collaboration or the participation, the active participation of the Kenema, let's say the Kenema team, or the what we call the Kenema unit, because it gave us the opportunity to put directly theory into practice at the same time, no? So what were the results? What was the energy picture that we found out? Well, we saw, based on the data of MSF OCB, Operational Center Brussels, sorry, that we are an organization that are very diesel dependent. Almost 80% of our energy needs are covered by diesel. And that means that our fuel consumption, it's 5,000 square meters liters per year. And we spend almost 5 million euros per year just in fuel consumption. If we translate this to CO2 emissions, we see that the numbers are quite high. And if these numbers doesn't say you anything, we can see that this is equivalent to going 1,000 times around the world with a Toyota Land Cruiser, that is the MSF normal vehicle. So I think it's we think that are numbers that are quite astonishing, let's say. With this, what did we do with this? This data, it was very useful in order to design the Kenema's energy strategy. First, we evaluate what was the installed power that we had in the hospital, and the average energy consumption. And based on that, we decided to go instead of a traditional MSF energy setting that is centralized and using generators or gensets. As we were dealing with a long-term solution, because the hospital is foreseen to be, I mean, we are planning to have it for 10 years, let's say, we designed a semi-decentralized solution using generators, but also using solar panels, solar photovoltaic solar panels. So that gave us a more diversity of the energy sources, a more robust system, let's say, and also it's not so fuel-dependent. And for doing that, also, we took into consideration the what we call the energy system perspective. So we didn't put all our focus in the energy supply. We took into consideration all the processes of the energy chain from generation to consumption. That means we studied the demand side management, the energy efficiency, possibilities of energy storage, and several power sources. Finally, what we design is we would have like five energy supply technologies. There is a mistake here. This is the same, but it's five. So we have four generators, 3 + 1. Then we will have generators and PV panels, the possibility to have batteries, energy storage, the possibility also to have city power. Now we don't have city power on site, but maybe it would come in 2-3 years. We don't know. So we have this possibility. And also we do consideration to use solar water heaters for heating the water for the laundry, for example, that is very energy consuming. Opa. With this, what we have is we would have a return on investment of 6 years, being the total investment for the three construction phases, or the 3 + 2 construction phases, of 2.5 million euros just for the energy side. But with this, we would see that once we recover the investment, we can have a running cost reduction in 4 years of 2 million. So we could even build another hybrid system. And of course, if we see the CO2 reduction, if we compare it, if we would have the business as usual MSF energy setting, that it's with generators, we have a CO2 reduction in 10 years of 75%. Well, just to finish a little bit, we saw that the energy vision gave us the framework or the conditions to achieve innovative solutions to energy-related challenges. We put this into place in the Kenema's energy setting, and this gave us also the opportunity to improve the current energy settings that we are facing within the organization. And what is more important, I would say also, is to have a stronger link between the final services and the energy systems, not to put only the focus on technology, but in everything that is beyond that. No? Now what we have to do, the next steps, is to develop a proper follow-up strategy for the implementation and also for the operation, and to see how are we going to capitalize all these lessons learned, and we can replicate and disseminate all the lessons learned that we would have. But of course, we have a lot of challenges to face. First of all, I would say that it is short-term versus long-term vision. We saw that even if the project is foreseen for 10 years, the investment, we will recover it in 6 years, more or less, and this is a quite long term for MSF, even more than 1 year. So we need to, this is a big challenge that we need to face. That is linked also to a mindset change. We need to go we are moving on from an electricity to an energy perspective, so not just focusing on the energy supply, but on all that is beyond, and from products to services, no? That is based on the energy system perspective. And finally, one thing, because this is, even if it's not a new technology, it's quite new for MSF, we need to find a specific expertise, not only to design, but also to do the operation and maintenance, no? of the energy systems. And well, I would like to finish this just thanking all the people that was involved in both projects, the John Pearson from the Innovation Unit, also the team from the Swedish Innovation Unit, all the team from the Kenema Unit, and I would like to say, even if it's not here, thank you for the energy team that was participating in that, and especially one member that it was part of both projects, that is Agustin, so thank you very much.